Spiritual connection with KSHE, because that baptismal eruption in 1967 that really happened in Detroit on WABX, in Boston on WBCN, and I believe there was one in San Francisco, the call letters evade me right now, but KSHE was that first initial throb of uninhibited free-for-all rock and roll radio. And I was here 40 years ago when that happened. So I've always referenced St. Louis and this whole heartland with KSHE Radio. So to be inducted into the KSHE Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, I believe that this is probably an honest Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. It probably doesn't have... Who were some of the numbnuts they put in here recently? I am truly honored. I am moved because the circle shall go unbroken. Chuck Berry started it here. I genuflected at the altar of Chuck Berry and all his musical genius that inspired this whole thing. And to be so recognized as the son of Chuck Berry in St. Louis on KSHE is a moment of pride and glory. God bless the KSHE dream. I got me a rock and roll band, it's a fever all. I've always loved the intimacy of a club, and that's where the Amboy Duke started, where you only had to play when you first start. And so you look in people's eyes and you kind of get the feedback, you get that emotion, you get that spontaneity, you get that primal scream, eyeball to eyeball, flesh to flesh, sweat communication going. However, the only thing better than that is when you have 80,000 people doing the same thing and you're not only able to look at the people in the front row and get that wang-dang, sweet-poon-tang thing going because it was hot and sunny and my, you're dressed in barely visible attire and you look so charming that way. Plus the magnification of this sea of humanity where all the clenched fists and all the howling, laughing, smiling faces and the dancing are absolute an extension of the music and the rhythms that you're playing on stage. I remember it well. And those were historic landmarks. In fact, we still do concerts with REO Speedwagon and with Heart and with Aerosmith and with Cheap Trick, which were the nucleus of those concerts back then. And we all talk about that kind of stuff, specifically about the Busch Stadium concert. So, yes, I was a lucky man to be a part of it.